Yo, what's up guys? Today we are reacting to another SpaceX video, and this is a suggestion from one of you, one of the subscribers here on the channel, and they said you should watch the video they in their channel called How Not to Land an Orbital Rocket Booster. You would see why this kind of thing is normal for a test. Also, they always disable the chat in their stream for every launch or event. If you're curious why, I suggest you see the NASA live stream. Okay, so I probably have an idea of why. I think there are many haters out there, but I will check the live stream to see what type of comments y'all be leaving NASA. Okay guys, don't forget to like and subscribe. If you haven't seen my last video, then yeah, go check it out on my channel. So this is kind of a new style of reaction on my channel. I normally do music and culture stuff, but space stuff is new to me, so I have no idea what I'm watching. So I read the comments so that you guys can help me out here. So even though my name is Teacher Paul, just to make things clear, I'm not a science teacher. I'm just, you know, enjoying the view from here. How not to land an orbital rocket booster. Let's go. This is straight from... That's loud. This is straight from the SpaceX channel. September 2013. Hard impact on ocean. Bro. You're telling me SpaceX has been blowing up rockets since 2013? Wow, that's nice. I love the song that they put. It's just a scratch. Ooh. Ow. Well, that is Elon Musk humor. It did land, just not in one piece. Oh, so close! No! Boom! Look, that's not an explosion. It's just a RUD. Okay, so in the previous video, I mentioned that they were using this abbreviation, RUD, just not to say it exploded, and you guys were on my back about that. I was joking, you know, and it was clear that the commentators were also joking, you know, when they said that. They said, this is what we call a rapid unscheduled disassembly. And this is kind of like, if you check Elon Musk's Twitter and if you watch him, like, you know, just for a little bit, like I do. I don't watch him a lot, but you know, you can see that he has this type of humor. So I can see that probably this came from him, this RUD, rapid unscheduled disassembly. Guys, it's actually very fun to watch this. I don't know why. It's like, for other people, it's like their hopes and dreams are falling and exploding. But after you see that, you know, they keep on going, and even though failure is, you know, clear here, it's not all lost, because without failure, there's no gains, right? Without failure, you cannot analyze and assess the problem. And when I was studying business, was it business 101, 1.0? I can't remember now, it's been so long. The first thing that you need to figure out for a successful plan is assess the problem. So if this is something that hasn't been done before, then you have to assess the problem to find solutions. So here we see the problem. It's blowing up. Okay, so apparently what you guys have been explaining to me is that they do these tests to gather data so that they can fix, tweak, improve, and then build another one. So they don't mind if it blows up. Of course, they do mind, because it's expensive, and but you know what I'm saying. They keep making it better and better and better, because this is what they call, I think, delayed gratification. So I think maybe this applies here. What happens is, you know that in the long run, this will be beneficial, and even though you lose money now, you will gain it in the future. Because imagine if space travel is possible. Imagine if you can travel from New York to Japan in 30 minutes. That is something that, you know, will change the course of history and travel, and, you know, so it's worth going through this process now, building a strong and capable rocket thing, something that has never been done before in terms of cost efficiency, in terms of, you know, making it, is it recyclable? No, reusable, as in the rocket can take off and can land. If that is possible and that is safe, then that changes everything, because nobody has ever done anything like that, where you can travel on a rocket, you know, take off and land. So I can understand why this is just, you know, hey, it's a book. Okay, I understand that it hurts when a rocket blows up, but I know that I understand why they weren't so phased, because this has been happening since 2013. The song says it all. Wow. Bro, what is going on here? Ow. They had a successful landing in 2015. Oh, but the rocket isn't as big as Starship. I've heard that Starship was the biggest, but this was a drone, right? Of course, it looks bigger. I mean, it is bigger than it looks, I suppose. That's what he said, I guess. Okay. Because she wouldn't say that, right? Okay, so this is a fun video. And guys, I just want to finish this off by saying, the reason I mentioned the sponsors and the investors in my last video was because I saw a video about why Mark Zuckerberg hates Elon Musk or something like that. And it mentioned that Elon Musk launched a satellite that kind of like exploded or something, and Mark's servers were in there, something like that. So kind of like Elon destroyed Mark Zuckerberg's project properties, and that's why they hate each other or something like that. So that's why I mentioned, you know, the investors would be upset seeing the Starship blow up. But all in all, it was a successful mission, according to what everybody has been saying, because the idea was to gather data. My first impression was that they wanted to go around the globe and then try to land the rocket. I don't know. But that wasn't what happened. Apparently it was detonated so that it wouldn't cause any damages. This is roughly what people have been saying in the comments. So it was detonated by the people. It was kind of like they pushed a button and it blew up, or I don't know how that works. But it failed to detach, and the mission was it was scheduled for an hour and a half, I think 90 minutes. It took 4 minutes to blow up, but still it was considered a success because of all of this data gathered. But obviously you don't want a ship to blow up 4 minutes after a 90-minute schedule. You know, that's not really what everybody wanted. But still, it was farther than many people wanted it to, or expected it to go. Anyways, guys, I've been rambling too much. This was fun. Thank you for the suggestion. If you guys want more SpaceX videos, just bear in mind that I'm learning. I'm not teaching, okay? So these are not educational videos. They're just purely entertainment. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in the next video. If you guys recommend me something, and tell me why NASA's live stream is it toxic? Is it like a toxic environment? Are people like really haters or something? I don't know. Keep the peace in the chat, okay? And I'll see you guys soon. Have patience. Take care. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.